I'm wishing on a star.
My name is Virginia, and I live on the edge of the forest. Well, kind of. My dad's a janitor. That's how we got to have an apartment on the edge of Central Park. And you might think that the fact that I still live with my dad is a bit sad, and, well, you might be right. But I don't know, I'm all he's got, really, and I'm sort of permanently between boyfriends at the moment, so, you know. I'm just a waitress at the Grill on the Park. But one day, I'm going to find a partner and open a restaurant of my own. All I need's a good man who's interested in food.
You see this? Look at this. This has been chewed. It's not my job. This is an electrician's job. But who gets to do it? Where are you going?
To work, Dad, like I do every day.
On the way back, use the stairs, just in case.
Who's there?
So where exactly are we going?
To Beantown in the southwest corner of your kingdom, sir. You're accepting the throne that the craftsmen there have made for your coronation.
Well, is it much further? Can't we stop and go hunting or something?
Very shortly, sir. We must make a brief stop at the Snow White Memorial Prison.
Oh, I hate these outer provinces. People are so common.
Your stepmother has applied for parole again, which we will, of course, turn down. It's simply a routine courtesy visit.
Yourselves trolls, you make me ashamed.
Sorry, Dad.
Sorry, Dad. It won't happen again.
This is the last time I come and rescue you.
Come on, Dad. Take off the magic shoes.
I can handle them.
You know what I'm starting to think? I'm starting to think that the only kind of people they want in this country are guys like me. You know, guys who will work for scraps, do six jobs, basically bend over and take it. There's something, darling, 10, 15 years tops. This country is finished as a democracy. I'm telling you, as a caring society, where people do things for each other. We're done, we're finished, we are out of here.
Your barbecue ribs are on top of the microwave.
Tony, I have been calling this elevator for the last half hour. I thought you fixed it.
Oh, I did, sir, but it's broken again.
Well, don't take all night on it. You've got to look at that boiler. It's driving everybody crazy. There's air in the pipes. The whole system's got to be drained and bled.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I just have to fix the leak in number 9, and then I'm right on it.
Tony, I'm only going to tell you this once. There are an awful lot of people out there who would love your job. An awful lot of people.
Yes, sir. Drain the system. I'd like to drain his system.
Bye, Daddy.
Oh, listen. Don't go through the park. You promise?
Yep.
If you got a coat, you're gonna get cold. Oh, why don't you fix me for dinner?
Wait. Come to me.
The red carpet treatment.
I'm sure they won't have forgotten about our visit, Your Majesty.
Shocking, no.
Oh, you were right.
Maximum security. We're not supposed to be in here.
Dad, no one's ever allowed in there. This is where they keep the Queen.
Open the door to everything you desire.
Giles? Giles! Hello?
Castle Wendell, perhaps you should have stayed there. My silly little stepson.
You will pay for this.
On the contrary, I think that you will beg at my feet for food. Do you know what this is? This is a very special kind of dog. This is a magical dog. I hope you like dogs, Wendell. You're going to spend the rest of your life as one. Wendell, you don't greet people on all fours, do you?
Get him!
Stop him! Bring him back to me alive!
No, he's not going anywhere!
He can't escape! We're in a prison!
Well, Your Highness, just what do you have to say for yourself?
Where's my tail gone?
I guess you get to a certain age and you realize that nothing exciting is ever going to happen to you. And maybe that's just the way it is. You know, maybe some people just have quiet lives.
Give us something to eat. I haven't had any food since yesterday.
Let us out. Come, just give us the key. Let us out.
You.
Hello.
What are you?
Me? A very, very fine chap, falsely imprisoned.
Do not make me ask again. If I give you your freedom, you must agree to serve me without question.
Oh, breakfast, lunch, dinner. I am your wolf. Loyalty is my middle name.
I've turned Prince Wendell into a dog.
Good idea.
Find him before the trolls.
Trolls?
Wait! Give your will to me. Be mine to summon and control. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Maybe we should claim this kingdom.
That's a sensational idea. Let's grab it before someone else does.
I hereby claim this land and all its inhabitants in the name of the Troll Nation. Henceforth, it shall be known as... What shall we call it?
The Tenth Kingdom. The Tenth Kingdom!
In a month, I will have crushed the House of White. I will have Wendell's castle and his kingdom. And for helping me to escape, you may have half his kingdom to rule.
Half the Fourth Kingdom, but it's huge. What's your plan? What do I have to do?
It's simply allow me the use of your children until they've captured the prince for me.
That's all.
Tell no one what you've seen, of course.
Do I get to choose which half of the kingdom I want?
Oh my God, I've killed it. Are you okay? Oh, I'm sorry. Where's your master? How come you don't have a collar?
Here, there's been an incident.
Aha! Looky, look!
Dog hairs.
Casting, nicey nice. Squeaky clean.
Return to Virginia Lewis, apartment 2006, number 2, East 81st Street.
81st Street?
Yeah, that's what it says, 81st.
How about this way?
Come on, let's go!
Come on, let's go!
My bike, and I lost my wallet, and I've picked up a new boyfriend.
Oh! Well,
I hit him with my bike, but I don't think he's hurt. I mean, he's not bleeding or anything.
What's his name?
I don't know. He doesn't have a collar.
Huh? Well, let's see. You look like a prince to me, huh?
Yes.
Hello, prince.
Hello. Hello.
Came here for. Find the prince. Find the prince. But of both. The wolf's gotta eat, hasn't he? Can't work on an empty stomach. I smell dog! Would you believe it? Work and pleasure combined.
All right, you can stay in here and I'll come back when I can and check on you. Don't make a noise or you'll get me the sack.
The special's all lamb.
Lamb! New season's lamb, I hope. Young and juicy, and frolicking provocatively in the fields, bouncing up and down with soft, fluffy wool. Stop it! Pull yourself together. Some shepherdess, not really paying attention to the flock. Probably asleep if I know little girls. Well, I'm not gonna eat her. Not if there's a lamb fillet. Or a nice fat rack of chops? I'm not greedy. Well, I am greedy. I don't know why I just said that. I have a substantial appetite. Born to gorge.
That's me. Cooked. When I say rare, I mean just let it look at the oven in terror, then bring it out to me. No fries, no vegetables, just meat. Red. As a young girl's first blush.
Oh, I'm sorry. I missed that.
A jug of margarita, a diet cola, and two beers, okay?
And my wife will have.
I'm sorry. I'll be right back.
A double big.
All right, that's it. I'm taking you outside. Okay, Candy, very funny. You can come out. I suppose you wrote that, eh? Bark once. Okay. Bark twice.
Okay, so you got the lamb special and 6 glasses of warm milk.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I almost forgot. I'm looking for this lovely lady who found my doggy.
Oh, so it's yours. Uh-huh. I'll tell Virginia. She's out back.
Can you understand everything I'm saying?
So stop it!
Well, who's in danger? Both of us? Whoa. Just wait a minute.
Oh, you can't come in here. She must have gone home, you know? Maybe she hurt herself when she fell.
Oh, poor little sausage. Why don't you tell me where she lives? That way I can thank her.
Oh, well, I can't tell you where she lives. You know, I don't know who you are. Oh.
You can tell me.
This is my stop. You gotta go now. Okay, you can just stay one night and then you're on your own. Do you understand? I've gone crazy. How can I be talking to a dog? Yes, I have. Don't try and reassure me. That's Mrs. Graves from next door. And her husband. Your son, Eric. What's happened to them? Wait here. Shh, wait. I'm gonna go see if Dad's all right. Thank you.
Nice, nice.
Walk the catwalk.
Hello there, girlie. These shoes, they've been very badly cared for. They're scuffed and then cracked and neglected.
You have nice shoes and so tiny.
We have hundreds of pairs at home.
So we know what we're talking about.
Who are you and what have you done to my dad?
Ah, he's just sleeping. Hit him with a bit of troll dust, that's all.
Troll dust?
I am Birdie the Troll, feared throughout the Nine Kingdoms.
I am Blabberwort the Troll, dreaded throughout the Nine Kingdoms.
And I am Bluebell the Troll, terrified throughout the Nine Kingdoms. So, where is he?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Prince Wendell!
Who?
The dog! We are going to count to three, and then we are going to make you into a pair of shoes.
One! I'll cut the shoes.
Two! I will shape the shoes.
Three! I will stick.
All right! All right! I'll tell you where he is. He's here. He's just, outside.
Show us! Take us to him!
Out of the car! Be careful!
Where is he?
He's hiding behind those doors.
That room was not there a moment ago. You are crafty.
There's no one in here!
Oh, yes, he's here. I'm just gonna operate the secret door and show you where he's hiding.
No! It's a trap! Fucking hell!
I think it's you they're after.
Oh, whatever it is, go away.
Good evening. Trolls have been to visit you first, I see. No matter. Tonight, and tonight only, I am authorized to make you a unique offer. Namely, the end to all your personal and financial problems.
Hey, just hold it a second, right there. You take another stab, I'm gonna call the cops as private
property. Under the terms of this policy, I am, in exchange for information as to the whereabouts of your daughter, able to offer you this magic bean, which, once eaten, will give you 6 glorious wishes. Is this her? This can't be her.
What do you mean?
Oh, she's succulent! What a dreamy, creamy girl! Tasty or what? This is quite the worst spell we have ever been put under.
We've had some stinkers, but nothing like this. Wow. She's a powerful little witch, that one.
I think we might be in her pocket.
What?
I think she might have shrunk us and put us in a matchbox in her pocket.
That's ridiculous.
ridiculous. You're falling to pieces. Get a grip on yourself. How can we be in a matchbox, you idiot? Where are all the matches?
What the hell's it doing?
Six big wishes. Imagine having anything you desire.
And from the look of your modest surroundings, I'm sure there are many things that you'd love to change. Get the hell out of my apartment, all right? This is a joke, right?
No, it's a standard multiple wishes deal. Six wishes. No going back on wishes once made, no making five wishes and wishing for another 1,000. Now, come on, is that a fair deal or what? Now,
where is your lovely daughter? What do you want her for?
Simply to reclaim my little doggy, which she found earlier.
Dog.
There's even a reward involved, which I intend to give her personally.
If she's not at work, she'll be at my mother-in-law's. Ooh. She's always trying to turn Virginia against me.
Does this mother-in-law like flowers?
She likes money. That's the only thing that impresses her.
Address, please. It's been a pleasure.
Wait, hold on a second. How long does this take to work?
Oh, don't worry. The first 3 hours...
Anything I want, huh? Okay. All right. For my first wish.
Hello?
Who is it?
It's only me, Grandma.
Oh.
Hi.
Oh, for a moment there, I thought it was your mother.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you. Would you mind if I stayed the night tonight?
You know, she'll come back one day. She'll just swan in without a word. You don't think she could be in Aspen, do you? She always loved the snow.
Well, I think she would have come back by now. I don't know, 14 years is a long time for après ski.
Don't be cheap, dear.
This is a stray I picked up today.
Well, just keep him away from Roland. He's probably got fleas.
Fleas, do you have fleas? No.
Shh. Shh.
Thanks.
You know, you could still be something in society, Virginia. I have connections, you know. Your mother's debut at the Ritz-Carlton was... coronation. At 19, she could have had any bachelor in the whole of New York. And what does she end up with?
Dad.
Dad. Don't throw away your life the way she did, Virginia. I can see the whole thing happening all over again. You're a waitress, for God's sakes. Who are you gonna meet? Some eligible short order cook?
No.
Oh. So, of course, you never fixed the pipes like you promised. That I've come to expect. But this!
I can explain all of this, and I'll get on it right away, Mr. Murray.
No. I'm gonna get on it is not good enough. I want you and your daughter out of this apartment today! You're fired!
Fired?
fired. No, please, Mr. Murray.
What, you big jerk?
I wish you and your entire family would kiss my ass and be my slaves forever.
What did you just say? Oh, master.
How long do you think the spell will last?
It can't last long.
100 years?
At most. Maybe only 50.
Well, we'll just have to make the most of our imprisonment and agree not to eat each other.
Absolutely, absolutely. We'll do the 100 years, and maybe, if we're lucky, we'll only have to do 2/3 of the spell and get out early.
There must be some mistake. I do apologize. I was looking for Virginia's grandmother.
I am she.
It cannot be. Her young sister, perhaps. Her mother, perhaps. But her grandmother? Pah! You are a dazzling beauty.
Oh. Well, I don't have my makeup on or anything yet.
Oh, may I come in? I have flowers.
Yeah, but who are you?
I am Virginia's suitor, her betrothed.
Betrothed? She didn't say anything about a fiancé.
How like her, how modest. Most girls would brag and boast about dating the heir to an enormous fortune, but not Virginia.
Oh, well, do come in. Mm, yes. I'll just go and get dressed.
Of course, get dressed.
Okay, Wishmaster. Give me a never-ending supply of beer. 2? You call it a wild night where you come from? Just keep... What are you doing?
I'm worried that they're not clean enough, Master. Shall I lick your shoes again?
Let me see your tongue. All right, 5 more minutes. How is your mother coming with that door?
Oh, almost done. No, Master.
Well, just hurry. No, stop. No, no, no. Once was enough. Here, open this for me. What should I wish for next? I wish. I wish I had something that would clean this apartment all by itself and I would never have to lift a finger.
Oh, here we go, here we go.
You would look better surrounded by potatoes.
Where's the garlic? The rosemary.
Oh! What do I have to work with here? 3-year-old dried herbs?
You're not gonna fit in the oven, are you?
Not in one piece, anyway. Makes quite a mess. The little lambs are lovely. Shepherdess.
What am I doing?
I should untie you. Oh, a poor old lady frightened out of her wits. I should untie you. But first I'll put a dollop of fat in the oven tray.
Grandmother?
Oh, guests are up. Breakfast isn't ready.
Some coffee or toast or something? What's wrong? You've got a cold? Grandma?
Surprise! Boy, oh boy, you're fantastic! Your picture doesn't do you justice! Wow! Oh no! How did this get here? No, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. By the way, where is the dog? Sleeping in final royalty. Oh, you smell great. I've had little teasers of your scent before, Virginia, but in the flesh. Perfumes are not for me. No, I respond favorably to the audacity of a woman who flaunts her own aroma. And you, Virginia. You smell like Sunday lunch.
Keep away from me.
Oh, beautiful eyes, beautiful teeth. All the right stuff in all the right places. No doubt about it, I am in love. Now that I've seen you, eating you is out of the question. Not even on the menu. Now, I know this is going to come out of the blue, but how about a date? We started badly, but I take all the blame for that. Oh, come on, give us a chance, please. Oh, you are one dynamic lady. There's no question there.
Get up. Listen, you've already kissed me 3 times today.
Let me kiss you again, Master.
No! Go clean something. You're getting ridiculous.
Master, oh, wonderful Master. My wife has a surprise for you.
Oh, really? Well, I'll take care of her. You go get me a beer.
Yes, Master.
It's my husband's Rolex Oyster. Solid gold.
You sure it's not one of those cheap imitations?
Oh, no, Master. I bought it for my husband's 40th birthday, but you must have it. All our possessions are yours now.
Murray, I'm going to take your wife out and buy her some underwear.
Of course, Master! Can I help yourself?
Master! I think there might be someone trapped in the elevator. I can hear voices and banging.
Yes, well, you know what? I don't know if you've noticed, but I'm no longer Mr. Fix-It. So why don't you get your rich behind out there and fix it yourself?
Oh, at once, Master.
I think we need some spending money. Wishmaster, how about $1 million? Oh, yes,
is.
Say hello to Benny.
Can I help you?
Oh, I hope so. I'm very confused.
You must be Paul's referral. He said you'd drop by to make an appointment.
Can you tell me what I'm doing here?
Let's get to know each other a bit before we tackle the big questions, okay?
Yeah, big questions.
Now, I'm going to give you a word. And I want you to say the first word that comes into your mind, okay?
Okay, yeah.
Here we go. Home.
Cooking.
Coward.
Chicken.
Wedding.
Cake.
Dead.
Meat.
Sexual.
Appetite.
Love.
To eat anything fluffy. Sorry. More than one word. Start again.
You know what, Murray, this is ridiculous. No, stop, listen. I want everybody out of here, except your wife. I had no idea you had so many relatives.
Of course, Master.
You can go.
Be with you in a moment, Murray. Just got to pucker up to the Master.
Don't pucker. Hey, cut that out. Hey, what are you doing?
This terrific girl, and I really, really, really like her. But the thing is that...
Look, come on, say it. Say it.
Not sure whether I want to love her or eat her. Oh.
Oh.
Of course, I blame my parents. They were both enormous. They couldn't stop eating. Every day I came home from school, it was eat this, eat that, eat her.
You shouldn't punish yourself.
No, I should. I'm bad. I'm so bad. I've done so many bad things. But that wasn't me, you see. That was when I was a wolf. Oh, Tuck, I want to change. I want to be a good person. Oh, can't the lion cuddle up with the lamb? Can't the leopard rub out all its spots?
This is the exact spot where I found you, so this is really where we have to go our separate ways. Okay? Look. I'm not the adventure type, you know? I mean, I'm a waitress. This is just really... This isn't my thing. Whoever these people are who want you, they can have you. No, I gotta go. Goodbye. I gotta go.
Here is a reading list I strongly recommend now.
Okay.
Why don't you come back and see me next week?
Oh, but you don't understand. I will be here next week.
You're not going to intimidate me with suicide threats.
Okay, but...
if you cooperate and give us the dealer's name, maybe I'll put in a good word for you.
Dealer? What dealer? I'm not taking drugs.
Yeah, right. That's right. You don't remember stealing the money because you were under the influence of these magic mushrooms, right?
Magic mushrooms? No, I didn't take... well, I swallowed the bean, but I didn't...
I've almost fixed the elevator now, Master.
We will break this spell. Trust me.
I trust you.
I trust you more. No, I trust you more. I trust her more.
I trust her more.
I've always trusted her more.
Fucking hell!
I can't anymore! Run! 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 We're moving.
We're going down.
Is that good or bad?
We are about to enter the underworld. Prepare yourselves.
This isn't the underworld, you idiot! This is where we came in.
Magic indeed! How did she do that?
Suck an elf!
Sometimes I like sheep.
Excuse me. I need everything on this list and anything else you might think is useful. Please, miss. Thank you very much. And if my plan is successful, I will certainly invite you to the wedding.
That's mine. That's mine, too.
Hey, couldn't we come to some kind of deal? You know what? I can give you anything you want, anything, whatever. I'm serious. A house in the Hamptons, boats, cars, women, whatever you want.
You won't make it any better trying to bribe us. Well, what have I got to lose?
I wish I could escape from this police car right now.
The brakes have failed.
How to marry the girl of your dreams is exactly what I'm looking for. Oh my God!
Because I don't know where you came from. No, look, this really is it, okay? Good luck. Dad? Dad!
You won't believe what's happened to me.
Don't bet on me.
Wait. Come on.
I don't think he is a dog. He's trying to say something, talk to me or something, but I can't understand what he's saying.
Trying to talk.
Yeah, I don't know.
All right, you watch this. I wish that I could understand everything this dog is saying.
You're in terrible danger, both of you.
He won't.
If you value your life, you have to do exactly as I say.
Dad.
Listen, what?
We have to find the way back.
He's talking. He's talking. Can't you hear him?
No.
People are.
Come here.
What?
Why are all these cops after you? And why are you wearing handcuffs?
They think I did a bank job.
I'll explain later.
Would you two stop rabbiting and help me find the mirror? Now, it's a mirror, but it may not look like a mirror from the other side. You have to look very, very carefully.
We're looking for a magic mirror.
Yeah, of course we are.
Just look for a piece of forest that doesn't fit. Oh, I'm sure this is where a... Look!
I don't... What?
There it is.
That's weird.
There they are!
If you value your lives, follow me.
Come on.
Follow me.
Dog said follow him.
Hurry up! Thing that happened to you, old chap. Troll dust.
Looks like it's starting to wear off.
Is that dog talking again?
So, what shall we do when we have our own kingdom?
I know. We'll have servants. Thousands and thousands of servants to polish our shoes.
Dad? Let's go home.
What? No, I can't go back yet. The police are swarming all over Central Park looking for me.
Well, we can't stay here.
Shh! I can smell the trolls.
He says he can smell trolls.
We'll have footwear parties where you have to change shoes 6 times an hour.
And anyone found having dirty shoes will have their face sewn up.
Come along, then. Follow me.
Hold on a second. I'm not going to follow you. Where are we?
We're in the southernmost part of my kingdom, where I was attacked by my stepmother and turned into a dog. This is the Snow White Memorial Prison, housing the most dangerous criminals in all the Nine Kingdoms.
All right, back up. The Nine what?
Kingdoms. I am Prince Wendell, grandson of the late Snow White, and soon to be crowned king of the Fourth Kingdom. And who might you be?
I'm Tony Lewis, janitor. And I think you already know my daughter, Virginia.
Troll Kingdom. Red Riding Hood Forest.
Wait, hold on a second. So what is this? Is that Cinderella, Sleeping Beauty, fairy tale stuff?
Well, the Golden Age was almost 200 years ago, when the ladies you refer to had their great moments in history. Things have gone downhill a bit since then. Happy ever after didn't last as long as we'd hoped. All the rulers of the other kingdoms are due to attend my coronation. Some will have to travel great distances. The kingdoms are vast. No one crosses the borders except on special occasions.
Hey, who was the stepmother who turned you into a dog?
She is the most dangerous and evil woman alive.
That sounds like my mother-in-law.
Look, we can't sit around talking all day. We must find my stepmother's cell. This way.
Virginia, you should follow him. Come on.
Outrageous.
What did she do, this woman?
She poisoned my mother and father. Tried to kill me as well.
Basically, poisoned his mom and dad and tried to kill him, too. Virginia, are you all right?
Yeah, I am.
weird being in here.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm just gonna wait outside for a minute.
The trolls have been here.
Okay, just don't go too far, okay? Stay outside the door. Virginia!
I wasn't scared. It's just that people mustn't see me as a dog, Anthony. It's deeply, deeply embarrassing. Ugh.
I could care less about you being a dog! Virginia! Virginia!
Where are they? I never should have trusted trolls to do anything.
Be careful what you say. I'm the only reason you got out of prison in the first place.
Of course, Your Majesty. And for that, I'm eternally grateful. But I can't stay here any longer. No one must see the prince like this. Have your children bring the dog to me when they return.
I am not your lackey. I am Relish the Troll King. And you will do well to remember it.
Of course, Your Majesty. And I will reward you handsomely with half of Wendell's kingdom, as I promised.
Just exactly when do I get it?
Soon. But now I must go. I've stayed too long already. Oh, get in there!
Where are you going? There's nowhere you can hide. When they find out you've escaped, there'll be roadblocks everywhere. They'll search every house and carriage in the kingdom.
Not every carriage.
And shouldn't we go back for the dog?
No, we can't. The troll dust will be wearing off. Wait a minute. Do you hear that? They're all waking up. Let's get out of here.
The queen will be very angry. The queen can suck an elf for all I care. We've captured the witch from the 10th kingdom. Let's go tell Dad.
But what about the witch's father? Perhaps he's a great warlock.
Well, he's handcuffed.
Great idiot, more likely.
I wish I could be there when the governor finds him in the queen's cell.
What are you doing? I've got to fight.
Some kind of spell. Me and the lad's been laid out for over a day. Searched every inch of the prison, but the queen's gone, sir.
I have been the governor of this prison for 12 years. No prisoner has ever escaped before.
That's a very impressive record.
Whatever you do, Anthony, don't tell him I'm a dog.
Why not? Speak when you're spoken to!
Because the queen has got some terrible plan. My whole kingdom may be in jeopardy. No one must know I'm helpless.
All right. Where is the queen?
I wish I was home. I wish Virginia and I were back in our apartment in New York. Now!
Well, it seems you're not.
No, Anthony, you didn't swallow a dragon dung bean, you moron.
I guess that means I've had all my wishes, huh?
How did the queen escape?
I'm telling you, I have no idea.
And why were you found locked in her empty cell?
I am an innocent victim. I've never been in trouble with the police my entire life.
And why are you wearing handcuffs?
Well, because I wanted to armed robbery, which I didn't have anything to do with either.
Carry on, Anthony. You're doing spectacularly well so far.
Look, I'm from a different dimension. I came here from a different dimension led by that dog, who is actually Prince Wendell.
I told you not to say that.
Prince Wendell. Look, I can make you break rocks with your teeth for 100 years.
I'm telling you, it's the truth.
That is the queen's dog. She has been permitted to keep him in her cell for 3 years. Don't insult my intelligence.
I'm not. I'm telling you, it's the truth. All right, fine. I'll prove it. Bark once if I'm telling the truth.
I have no intention of barking, Anthony.
He is being just stubborn. Listen, you have to let me go immediately. I think my daughter was abducted by trolls.
That's enough. I'll get the truth out of you soon enough. Warder, remove his handcuffs. Issue him with prison uniform and put him in... Ah, yes. put him in 103 with Acorn the Dwarf and Clayface the Goblin.
Clayface the Goblin? I don't want to be put in any room with Clayface! No! Listen, where's my daughter?
What about the Queen's dog, sir?
Get the furnace going. I'll slip some rat poison in his dinner tonight, and we'll chuck him in the incinerator tomorrow.
Did you hear that? Anthony? Did you hear that? You have to get me out. It's your duty.
Middle bunk.
So, what are you in for?
Actually, a pretty serious bank robbery. A couple of people got hurt. That's the way it goes. And you?
Aggravated assault. Very easily aggravated. I'm Acorn. Got any metal on you? Knives, forks, coat hangers.
Sorry.
If you get stabbed, save the knife for me, won't you?
Of course.
Do you like carving?
Well, not flesh or anything.
Look what I'm doing.
Ah. You've got real talent.
My name's Clayface the Goblin.
Tony. What are you in for?
Carving. Will you be my friend?
What exactly does that entail?
Bro! Say something one more time and I'll let you.
Keep growing, Blackboard!
Any minute now, I'm sure Prince Wendell will arrive to receive the coronation throne, which our craftsmen tirelessly spent the last 2 years making.
He's not coming, is he?
Of course he is. Have no worry. I'm sure he's been delayed for a very good reason.
Terrible news. There's been a breakout from the prison.
The Queen has escaped.
The Queen?
The Queen put up the roadblocks. She must be caught or we're doomed.
Hey, wonderful news! Wonderful news!
Prince Wendell is coming.
Thank goodness. He'll know what to do.
How did you know it was me?
You have a distinctive, unwashed smell. What are you doing?
I'm scrubbing the floor. What do you think I'm doing?
Have you got a soap bar?
Well, yes. What, do you want me to wash you?
No, just stay there. Don't go away. This is the governor's master key. Make an impression in the soap. He'll be back any moment.
Oh, here.
Very stubborn stain, sir.
Beanstalk.
Baked beans?
Beanstalk.
Oh my God! I can't eat that. It tastes like an old mattress.
No, it doesn't. Old mattress has a sweaty, meaty taste.
And how often is this on the menu?
3 times a day.
That's beanstalk juice. Takes a bit of getting used to.
Listen, let's say I wanted to talk to somebody. I wanted to get something made. For instance, for the sake of argument, a small piece of metal. Who would I have to talk to? I mean, who's Mr. Big around here?
If you want anything bought, sold, borrowed, or made in here, you have to see the Tooth Fairy.
The who?
The prison dentist.
To see him.
Oh, well, that's easy.
Oh, yeah?
That's no good. They'll all have to come out.
What do you mean, come out? You haven't even looked in my mouth yet.
Sit down.
I...
Would you like some candy?
What? You're a dentist. You shouldn't be giving people candy.
Why not?
Well, because it rots teeth.
They're rubbish.
Well, of course it does.
Well, excuse me. Who is the tooth extractor here, eh? You or me?
Well,
I'm just gonna...
Well, what are you doing?
I'm just putting the straps on.
Straps? What do we need straps for?
Yeah, the straps of comfort. Tooth decay is caused by 3 things. Number 1. Poor diet, 2, not brushing properly, and 3, bad fairies.
You know, I think I can,
what? Does that hurt?
Ah, huh?
Right. How about this? loose teeth. I thought so. Don't you worry. We have a bag of magic teeth here.
The kid got a knife. Yeah. I came to you for help.
Help?
I've got to get a key made out of this.
What's it worth?
Very intricately.
We call them watches.
Oh, but this is Rolex. Solid gold.
Well, as long as it's not one of those cheap imitations.
He just drove right through Bean Town without stopping.
That was on Wednesday, Lord Chancellor, and he hasn't been seen since. The throne makers are furious. They're threatening to boycott the coronation.
It's so unlike the prince not to send word of where he is.
Perhaps it's just coronation nerves. I'm sure he'll turn up soon.
Let us not forget that the evil queen is now at large.
Where is Wendell? Where is he in his kingdom's greatest hour of need?
Things look very bad indeed.
Terrible.
Quite awful. Still, I expect it'll all turn out happy ever after.
Oh, yes.
Now to the real crisis. There is a shortage of bluebells throughout the kingdom. My color scheme for the coronation banquet will have to be completely rethought.
Awake. Stripper.
Oh, my God.
You're a captive of the merciless trolls now.
Merciless.
Without mercy. Pretty little feet.
Nicey, nice.
Who runs your kingdom?
A kingdom?
Who's in charge?
The president!
Wendell was trying to rally an army from your kingdom to attack us, wasn't he?
No!
This could be a long torture session.
I'll tell you anything you want to know.
I torture first, then you talk. It's better that way. Rush a torture, ruin a torture. Dad's here.
Dad, why don't you take off the shoes?
In these shoes, I am all powerful. I can rule the world.
Come on, Dad, just slip them off.
Where have you been? You're a day late. Who's this? Supposed to bring back the dog.
Forget the dog, Dad. We've discovered another kingdom.
The mythical 10th kingdom.
Talked of only in myth.
Don't talk rubbish. There is no 10th kingdom.
Oh, but there is. And this witch put us in a box of matches.
You were captured by this girl.
She's a witch.
How many of their soldiers did you kill before you were captured?
None.
None survived.
Who wants to be whipped first?
It's true. Look at this. They are called the Brothers Gibb.
And the song, it concerns a deadly fever that only strikes on Saturdays.
More to all this than the queen
is telling me.
I was just coming down the hall and I tripped on the loose brick and I fell and I found myself right here in front of your door and I found this. Did you lose one?
Take him downstairs. I'll give him 50 beanstalk lashes. Right now!
No, that's not necessary. I was just coming by to ask you, do you have a laundry here? I
don't. Oh, dear. Sorry about that, Anthony.
You need a fuck. Don't you? But listen, I don't.
Here, boy.
What are you hurting me?
Here you are, doggy. That should give you a nice, long sleep.
Dance for me. And when you finish dancing, you'll tell me how to invade your kingdom.
I'm not much of a dancer, really, actually.
You'll dance when you wear these.
Wake me when they turn red!
Conceal the coach, then prepare a room for the prince.
Welcome home. We have missed you, Your Majesty.
Who's that?
She was the stepmother who poisoned Snow White with the apple. All those years ago. She was once the most powerful woman in all the Nine Kingdoms. And this was but one of her five castles.
What happened to her?
When she was finally caught, they heated a pair of iron slippers over red-hot coals and made her dance at Snow White's wedding. She crawled out into the snow, dragging her raw, blistered, useless feet into a swamp nearby. This broken woman who was once the fairest of them all. But she kept her magic mirrors and searched for a successor. And that, of course, was me. I will finish her work and destroy the House of White forever, and pity the fool who tries to stand up to me!